Hi, today's movie is the 1958 low-budget horror film The Screaming Skull. I don't really know what to expect, but I'm in the mood to hear some skulls screaming. Let's have at it. American International, can't go wrong. What's going on here? Is it a funeral? Okay, it's a funeral. We get it. That's a very long shot.
The Screaming Skull is a motion picture that reaches its climax in shocking horror. Its impact is so terrifying that it may have an unforeseen effect. It may kill you. Therefore, its producers feel they must assure free burial services to anyone who dies of fright while seeing The Screaming Skull.
Okay, I'm sold now. It might kill me and they'll pay for my funeral if I die. So, clearly, if I die during this video, please get money from the makers of The Screaming Skull. This reaction video might turn into a snuff film, so be warned. Aww. Oh. Run away, little froggy. Oh, what is this? I've got what I wanted. I heard a skull scream. Optimistic about this one. So far they've delivered on the promise of the title. We've had the screaming skull. The music's really creepy. I hope they can keep this up beyond the opening credits. Nice car. Wow, gullwing doors. How cool is that? So I guess they're newlyweds.
You'll need some fixing first.
It was her room, wasn't it?
Yes. Come on along, I'll show you the rest of the house.
So there's a dead former wife, I guess. It's a bit Rebecca-ish so far. Uneasy. The spectre of the former wife.
I forgot to carry you over the threshold.
Oh, who's this guy?
Nothing. I love you.
Jenni. I thought life had died
Got
out.
Got to have a creepy groundskeeper.
Jenni, this is Mickey.
How do you do, Mickey? I hope we'll be good friends.
Well, Mickey.
Thank you, Mickey. One of those rose cuts.
I sing
so I guess Mickey is the Mrs. Danvers of this movie. And I believe the guy who plays Mickey is actually the director of the movie. Cool sneakers, Mickey. Oh, this must be Marion, the former wife.
No. Send them away.
Hit her head on the edge of the cement wall where we're sitting. And she fell in there. She died in the water. That's where Eric found her 10 minutes later.
Mickey had something to do with it.
Wait here, Mickey said. And then you went away in the rain. And you didn't come back.
Yeah, skull under there.
What?
And don't forget that you and Eric are coming for lunch.
Dirty skull tease.
We'll do better than that.
Oh. They really tried hard with that scene, but I don't think it was as scary as I intended. Because the picture is really not very scary.
What is it?
Mickey's been in there.
I can't help it, Eric. That bad feeling's come back.
I forbid you to talk about it.
She looked like that, Eric. My mother looked like that.
Jenny. Besides, how could a very poorly done self-portrait upset you so much?
At least I admit it was a poorly done portrait. Oh!
I know it's only my own fear. It's my own guilt that I... Such a fool.
You feeling better now?
Yes.
Women are always so emotionally fragile. I'm guessing Mickey doesn't smell too great if he's always rubbing pond water on his face. Mickey looks like he belongs in a Californian rock band from 1969. That's quite creepy.
Mickey?
That portrait is kind of awful. The weird thing about this film so far is it's well made, it's well photographed, the actors are all really good. There's just no creepy atmosphere. Nothing really disturbing has happened. Oh, hello! They do seem to be putting a lot of emphasis on this lady's cleavage. There's nothing wrong with that. But I would like some ghosts and some more screaming skulls. Where's her husband? What's he up to? Mickey, being creepy. He's up to something. Golly. So if you found a skull, would your first impulse be to throw it out the window? I think I would check if it was real. Bit. I'm getting the feeling there's a bit of filling going on with this, all these shots of walking around corridors. We've only got an hour to fill in this movie. You shouldn't need filler in an hour-long movie. Who's knocking on the door at this time of night? Where is the husband? Get on with it, please. Yeah. More shots of walking around. Just answer the door. Seriously? If it's a tree making this noise, I'm going to be really angry. Oh, it's a skull! The skull is knocking on the door! That was a nice shot. The skull's chasing her. No, it's Mickey.
I knew she resented that I was not more like her. I used to lie awake at night and wish she were dead.
Well, that isn't very unusual. I understand many children go through such a period.
It's not very unusual to lie awake every night and wish your mother was dead. I don't know.
One day.
According to horror films, all women are just one scare away from complete mental collapse.
Peggy!
More shots of walking around. We need less walking around and more action. I just love that car.
Eric.
I have a term for bad art. I call them paintings because they give you pain, and I think this portrait is a painting.
It's only the peacocks.
Or is it? See, that was quite an effective sequence. They needed more like that.
Yes.
That was well done.
We can't let those ashes stand overnight. And the brush in these hills is a regular tinderbox. You want to help me? That's it.
Is there a skull under there? Yes.
What is it, darling?
The skull! It's the skull!
Darling, there's no skull there. There's no skull there, darling. There
is
no
on
skull
it.
There, Jenni. Darling, there's no skull there. There's no skull.
This is like Gaslight meets Rebecca, I guess. He's gonna drive her out of her mind so we can get her money. Oh, Mickey's seen it. Maybe Mickey's not the baddie after all. Get him, Mickey. I think the real ghosts of Marion should come back and get her revenge.
Peggy!
Because he probably killed Marion as well. Look at this, it is well photographed.
You saw me put it in the pond, you must have heard it.
Doesn't Mickey look like he should be on tour with the birds? His look is so ahead of its time.
Said that he didn't see it when Jenni saw it.
I know.
Oh, but why should Eric lie like that?
Mickey.
I do like the fact that they've all realized what's happening. I haven't seen that in a horror movie like this before. Knowing what was happening, shouldn't the friends and Mickey have warned her? Tried to protect her? That the husband dressed up as the dead wife, no? No! That ghost kind of looked like it was in blackface. I hope that's not the case. Oh, is he choking her? Bloody hell. Answer the door! Could have been done better. Was it really the ghost of Marion, or was it his friends trying to get their revenge on him? So they weren't there.
Eric tried.
Shh. Where is Eric?
Did he do it?
Your money. The question is now, did Marion die in an accident? I suppose we'll never know.
Be gone. Rest.
I suppose I expected the screaming skull to be kind of stupid or awful, and it really wasn't stupid or awful. The acting was fantastic, the cinematography was great, the direction was good. It takes some really interesting references, such as Gaslight and Rebecca, but it just doesn't know what to do with them. Is it a ghost story? Is it a psychological thriller? It's kind of both, but it doesn't really take either in far enough direction to be satisfying. It is only an hour long and it does feel padded out. They could have done so much more with these really interesting story elements that they have. Is the ghost of the dead wife Marion haunting the new wife Jenni, or is it all just the husband doing it? They never really make it clear, although it's implied that the husband is doing it. At the end, the ghost of the wife does come into play. I found the screaming skull a bit frustrating because, really, given all these great elements that it had in place, it should have been so much better than it was if only they'd paid a bit more attention to the story and the script. It's not bad, it is entertaining, it does have moments of scariness and some moments of great photography, but just not enough of them. Everyone in this film does seem to be making an effort, so it is a real shame that it doesn't come out to be something stronger than what it is. If you've enjoyed this video, I would love it if you would like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching today, and I hope I will see you next time. Bye.